Hello, welcome back to Elm Creek. So we are in our farmyard, which has now been finished. Still a bit uneven in the place or two, but I found the limitations of the landscaping tool. The house end is finished and sort of hidden some of the lumps and bumps. There's not too many around this way that needed looking at. Well, not that I'm too worried about anyway. Small ridges you go into the shed there, but that's not a great one. That's sunken down there, we've grassed everywhere. We've now got 100 pigs in each shed. These ones have yet to be fed, which is what today's video is going to entail. Or some of it anyway. That one we need to keep an eye on. Some very peculiar antics going on with these pigs when I first put them in there. And they're doing circuits out through the fence and round through the back of the shed. So I'm not quite sure what was going on there. We bought some machinery. So we've gone for the John Deere X9 combine, US spec, along with the maize header. Big grimy potato harvester because we need some potatoes. The rubber beet harvester will probably be short lived, but as we've got a field full of sugar beet, we might as well actually harvest them. Can't fill this in with a landscaping tool, so I found another limitation of it. But for the most part, everything else is set up now. So we need to head across the road to where I've bought actually a EU spec tractor, I'll be honest. This one, mainly down to the trailer I'm using to collect the pig food. So we've got a 7R over here, 7R 350, and the big triaxle trailer there. So we bought the pig food here just until we can start getting our own crops. Be the easiest way for now. Show how much food the sheds will take. We'll find out in a moment. Certainly more than one trailer full. Four bags in. Still as tricky as they ever were, these bags at times. Hoping the trailer full will actually just about fill one of the pens. Keep going. Not sure what that bag is doing there, but forks in a bit instead. I got two this time. So I'll get all these loaded up into the trailer and I'll see you in a few moments. Right, so we have one full trailer of pig food. So we've got to tip that into that shit. Still got a few bags left over as well, which we'll put into the other shed. Got a few more fields as well. All of this block to my right is ours, including one block of potatoes in there. And get the pigs fed. Straw will have to wait till we've got some. That shed is currently empty. Again. Oh, we've got a pig there that's deciding to do a circuit and bumps. So let's just check the feed situation there. Quite what that pig is up to, I don't know. So, good bit of food in there. 21,170. 24,000 in that one. I'm not quite sure why it's not allowing us to tip the whole lot in there in one go. Should take everything in there. There we go. So at least they're fed now, that's one thing. Those two pigs are certainly up to mischief. Across to one of our fields the other side of the road. I was going to be using manual attach on here, but it's playing up with the header trailer at the moment. In that you can't actually hook the header trailer on the combine once you've dropped it off once, because the drawbar keeps moving. Field of wheat here ready to go. That should give us some straw. Money no object at the moment, but that will be thinned down once we've got everything. This gives us a chance to fly some big kit. Hopefully I've laid the yard out right to get this round everywhere. Nothing like a brand new yard though, which is what I was hoping for. That manual attachment, I've turned the soft back on. Yep, it certainly has. Shouldn't take long to get this filled out, I wouldn't have thought. This lovely small combine. Sort out a baler then and a bigger tractor. Not too big a field of potatoes there, but enough to keep us going for a little while. The other field in front of us is ours as well. A few other fields dotted about. There's a field of sunflowers and a few maize fields as well. Certainly couldn't got a much bigger combine to do the job. What sort of bales we're going to be doing, it'll probably be big square ones I'd imagine. It also gives us some wheat for the pigs. Thank you. tried to pick fields of crops that the pigs were to have food on. So we didn't have to keep buying pig food all the time. Is that such a cheap exercise? Not. I think we need to get screenshots, we're doing this anyway. Let's put them all back in to hide them up. Give us some grain and some straw. So you're looking for a big tractor for doing the baling with. And cultivations, etc. See the difference the increased densities have made to this, what I've done. Much grain on here, but enough to get us started. We've got some other big fields to do. It's not fertilised at all, this field. So it's not going to yield its best. Anything's better than nothing at the moment. Make ourselves a wide enough width to get the header down there. That's our first field cut. One down, several to go, as I'll show you in a moment. Keep the pigs fed very long, but it's feed nonetheless. So as for what we actually own field wise, you You see there, we're way down on where we could be with food. So we need a few more in there, yep. Field wise, we've got the little block in here. Fields in here. One there, a couple in there. A big field of sugar beet there. Big field of sunflowers in there. Fields 31, 34 and 33 up there. So it should keep us going for a little while. But that's where we're going to be leaving this video. So I will say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you again in the next one. Goodbye.